Hi everyone, welcome to Miraculous Microbes. Today I would like to discuss about microorganism in the rhizosphere. In the last video itself, I explained about the rhizosphere and its effect. In this video, we are going to see detailly about the what are the microorganisms take part in the rhizosphere and its effects. Let's get started. First, I start with the introduction. The rhizosphere region is highly favorable habitat for the proliferation, activity and metabolism of numerous microorganisms. The rhizosphere microflora can be enumerated intensively by microscopic, cultural and biochemical techniques. Microscopic technique reveals the type of the organisms present and their physical association with the outer root tissue surface or root hair. The cultural technique most commonly followed is serial dilution and the plate count method, which reveal the qualitative and quantitative population of microflora. At the same time, the cultural method show the selective enhancement of certain category of the bacteria. The biochemical techniques used are designed to measure the specific change brought about by the plant or by the microflora. The rhizosphere effect are most commonly found in microorganisms like bacteria, actinomycetes, fungi, algae and protozoa. First, we are going to see detailly about the bacteria. The greater rhizosphere effect is observed with the bacteria than with the actinomycetes and the fungi. Gram-negative, rod-shaped, non-sporulating bacteria which respond to the root exudates are predominant in the rhizosphere. Example, Pseudomonas and Agrobacteria. While the gram-positive, rod, cocci and aerobic spore-forming bacteria like Bacillus, Clostridium are comparatively rare in the rhizosphere. The most common genera of bacteria are Pseudomonas, Arthrobacter, Agrobacterium, Alkaligens, Azotobacter, Mycobacterium, Flavobacter, Pseudomonas, Micrococcus and others have been reported to be either abundant or sparse in the rhizosphere. From the agronomic point of view, the abundance of the nitrogen fixing and phosphate solubilizing bacteria in the rhizosphere assumes a great importance. The aerobic bacteria are relatively less in the rhizosphere because of the reduced oxygen level due to the root respiration. The bacterial population in the rhizosphere is enormous in the range from 10 power minus 8 to 10 power minus 9 per gram of the rhizosphere soil. They covers about 4 to 10% of the total root area, occurring profusely on the root hair region and rarely in the root tips. There is a predominance of the amino acid and the growth factors required by the bacteria or readily provided by the root exudates in the region of the rhizosphere. Next is the fungi. In contrast to the effect on bacteria, plant root do not alter or enhance the total count of fungi in the rhizosphere. However, rhizosphere effect is selective and significant on specific fungal genera which are stimulated. Example, Fusarium, Penicillium, Aspergillus and Penicillium. The RS ratio of the fungal population is believed to be narrow in most of the plants, usually not exceeding to 10. The serial dilution and plating technique used for the enumeration of rhizosphere fungi may often give erratic result, that is the unpredictable result, as most of the spore formers produce abundant colonies in culture media, giving a wrong picture or wrong estimation. Example, Aspergillus and Penicillium. In fact, the mycelial forms are more dominant in the field. The zoospore or zoospore forming lower fungi such as the Phytophthora, Pythium, Aphnomyces are strongly attracted to the roots in response to the particular chemical compounds excreted by the root
and cause the disease under the favorable condition. Several fungi like Gibberella and Fusicorio produces phytohormones and influence the plant growth. Last group of the organisms are actinomycetes, protozoa and algae. Stimulation of the actinomycetes in the rhizosphere has not been studied in much detail so far. It is generally understood that actinomycetes are less stimulated in the rhizosphere than bacteria. However, when antagonistic actinomycetes increase in number, they suppress the bacteria. Actinomycetes may also increase in number when antibacterial agents are sprayed on the crop. Among the actinomycetes, the phosphate solubilizer like Nocardia and Streptomyces have their dominant role to play. As rule, actinomycetes, protozoa and algae are not significantly influenced by their proximity to the plant root, and their RS ratio rarely exceed 2:3:1, and around the root of the plant, the RS ratio for these organisms may go to high. Because of large bacterial community, an increase in the number of or activity of protozoa is expected in the rhizosphere. Flagellates and amoeba are dominant and ciliates are rare in the region. Thank you. I hope this video gives you an idea about the microorganism in the rhizosphere area. I will catch you at the next video related to the microbiology.